Hey guys, I'm Dave Chesson of Kindlepreneur, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use Amazon's free Kindle Create in order to turn your Word document into an Amazon-approved ebook file for submission on Kindle Direct Publishing. But before we get into that, if you'd like to learn more about book formatting, self-publishing, and book marketing, be sure to hit that subscribe button as well as the little bell icon to the right so as to get notified when my next video comes out. And with that, let's begin. To download Kindle Create on your desktop, you will first want to do a quick Google search for Kindle Create. Select the first link that you see here. Make sure that you are signed into your Amazon account, and then choose the proper download depending on your computer. From there, you can find the download and double click so as to install it. When you first go to open up Kindle Create, you will find the option to create new and another option to open existing file. For this tutorial, we're going to create a new document. On the left, you will see three options that are suited to the type of writing that you may be doing. The first option, reflowable, is better suited for essays, memoirs, poetry, and novels. Comics is a format made for graphic novels. And print replica is better suited for textbooks, cookbooks, magazines, and other image-heavy manuscripts. We're going to select reflowable and choose the file we want to import. Remember that the file you choose to upload must be a doc or docx file format in order to work. Kindle Create is then going to review your file for any chapter headings and subtitles, and with that, we'll create a table of contents. A pop-up box will appear that will allow you to accept or reject any of the chapter headings it may find, depending on how you want your book to be laid out and shown. Starting from the left of your screen, we are first going to see our contents page. Here, we can see all of our chapters under the body section and can add more by clicking the plus button. Under our front matter, we select the button here and add pages like the title page, copyright, and table of content. Back matter consists of pages like our about the author, epilogue, and afterword. If at any point you can't see this pane, just click the view button here to toggle it on and off. The first thing we're going to want to do once we have our document uploaded is select our book's theme. From here, you can select any of these select few themes offered. As you can see, there aren't many, so try to find something that fits your book. Depending on which one you select, you will notice that the elements on page are automatically updated to match. Now, you can go through your document and update any chapter title, subtitle, first paragraph to match all. Other elements that are not specific to your select theme are going to be located under the standard elements section. For example, if at any point you want to add a scene separator, you can simply come here and select the separator button, and Kindle Create will automatically format it to fit. If at any time you're curious as to what element might be used, you can easily click on the text, and over in the current element section, you can see what you have it formatted as. If you want to remove the element, just click clear. And if you wish to undo any changes, locate the undo button over here. Under the formatting tab, you will be able to find more generic text formatting options like bold, underline, text align, indents, and spacing. While most of this is pre-generated, if you wish to make any changes, this is where you will find the option to do so. To add an image to your manuscript, first place your cursor where you want the image to be and go up to the insert button here and select image. Locate the image and click open. If you wish to have your images viewable on a screen device, you will need to insert a short description here. If you don't care to have your image shown, you can select this box here and it will be marked as unnecessary content. Under the size, you can select to have your image as full bleed or smaller and select how you want it aligned around the text. Just be careful with images in Kindle Create. It tends to have problems with them, and adding in extra lines or placing part of the image on another page can be problematic. So check your previewer as well as exported files when you're done, just to make sure this didn't happen to you. To insert any hyperlinks into your manuscript, highlight the text, and if you are on a Mac, control click, and if you're on a PC, just right click. Insert hyperlink. Type in your link, making sure to include the https://, and then select insert hyperlink. To add your table of contents, you will need to first make sure that all of your chapter titles are set to the chapter title element. Once that is done, you can go to front matter tab, select the plus, and add table of content. Check to make sure that all of your chapters are there and click OK. On the right, you will be able to see the print version of your table of contents with the page numbers included. If at any point you want to delete any front or back matter, just simply right-click on the tab and select Delete. To save your document at any point, go up to the Save button here. Select the location you want it saved, title your work, and click Save. Just remember that in order to publish your ebook, you must have it saved first. The nice thing about Kindle Create is that they allow you to use the same file to publish your paperback or physical book on KDP. So if you plan on publishing on KDP, you will want to go to your page settings and select the way you want your heading and page numbers to look for the print version. When you're ready to preview your work, you can go to the preview button here and see the way it will look on several different devices like a tablet, phone, and Kindle e-reader. It's important to note that this does not include a lot of the other devices that are out there, but these three simple ones should work for this basic book. Once you're satisfied with your work and you're ready to publish, you can go to the Generate button here and get the file of your book that will be ready to be published on KDP. Now, as you can see, this will create a very basic looking book. However, there are some limitations and problems you should be aware of when using Kindle Create. First, when you go to export, Kindle Create will generate a KPF file and not an EPUB file, meaning that you can only use that file on Amazon and not on another market, since KPF files are rarely accepted by anyone else. Also, Kindle Create doesn't support footnotes or endnotes, volumes and parts, and is limited in your choices of fonts, special ornamental breaks, margin selections, and weight balancing. Another issue is that the Kindle Create file size that you export is extremely large as compared to the file sizes that programs like Atticus will create. This is incredibly important because Amazon will charge you, the author, 15 cents per megabyte for your file size every time somebody buys and downloads your ebook. So if your book is 3 megabytes large, every time you sell a book, Amazon will take 45 cents out of your royalties. It has been seen that generally a program like Atticus.io creates file sizes 2.5 times less than that of Kindle Create. With this in mind, if you end up selling over 800 ebooks in a lifetime, this alone will have a program like Atticus paying for itself. Also, as you saw, you will be highly limited in the themes you can use and how your chapters will look. Using a program like Atticus, you can create special custom themes like these with ease and can make your book look unique. All right, so with that, we've seen how to use Kindle Create as well as some of its limitations and some of the things you could do with a program like Atticus.io. And be sure to check out my next video as I show you how to upload that file into Kindle Direct Publishing for the best optimization as well as start to your book launch. And with that, I'm Dave Chesson of Kindlepreneur signing off. Cheers.